and have a Google, go on Spotify, thanks, and listen to some of his solo piano music, because it's just stunning and I think it should be played more. Next up, we're going to move to Poland. I'm going to play a piece by the Polish composer Szymanowski. This piece is quite personal to me because it was the reason that I went on Erasmus, funnily enough. I heard this piece in my old college, in undergrad, and thought, who is this composer? This piece is really beautiful. And when I was looking at different colleges for Erasmus, I saw there was a Szymanowski Academy. So I looked it up, thought it looked really great, wanted to go to Poland, and changed my life, really, and completely changed my musical outlook. This piece is one of his etudes, the third of four, and it's probably his most famous piece. And there was a quote that somebody met him at a party and they said, what a shame to have written your ninth symphony equivalent at such a young age. And apparently he was not happy because they thought he had peaked quite soon. So yes, this is his Szymanowski etude, opus 4, number 3.
Thank you.
in between kind of breaks up the nerves for me a bit. And I love to give a bit of fun facts about pieces, because as you can probably see already, I'm not playing this sort of usual repertoire. So up next, we have now gone back to Northern Ireland, my hometown, my home country. I'm going to play a set of five bagatelles by the composer Howard Ferguson. And I came across these pieces while I was studying at the Royal College of Music. And I found out about this composer, who is from the same country as me. He went to the same college as me. And these five pieces are sort of five little character pieces. They're all very, very different. And the fun fact about this is that he was actually suffering writer's block. So composers can get that as well. And he asked a friend, give me 25 notes and I'll write something with them just to get him started. So the dedication is here to his friend Arnold Van Wyk, who kindly contributed 25 notes. So these are the Howard Ferguson five bagatelles.
Thank you.
So moving on, what piano recital is complete without Chopin? But we've already had some Chopin, which fitted into my plan very well because one of my favorite forms of Chopin is the nocturne, which everybody knows means nighttime sounds. So they're very atmospheric, very colorful, very beautiful. And Chopin is famous for sort of pioneering the nocturne, but this is actually false. It was an Irish composer who came up with the nocturne, an Irish composer called John Field. Any pianist in Ireland will know this because you're really told it when you're a teenager. So I thought I would do three of my favorite nocturnes without Chopin. So I'm going to start with a nocturne by Respighi, who was an Italian composer, who many of you will know from Fountains of Rome, Pines of Rome. And again, just like Sibelius, big orchestral composer, but actually has some really beautiful piano music. So this nocturne, Notturno, as it is in Italian, is from his Six Pieces for Piano. And then I will play Debussy's nocturne. Now everybody knows Debussy's nocturnes for orchestra, but he has a solo piano one, which no one plays, and it's so beautiful. And then I will finish with John Field's nocturne number 10. So I'm gonna play these as a sort of set.
Thank you.
So I hope you can see three completely different nocturnes, very different styles, so it's not as boring as some people might think they are. They're my favorite. So the last piece in my set is another piece by Sibelius. I thought I would sort of bookend this little recital to really make sure you go home and Google his piano music, because it's just so fabulous. This is his Romance, which is, I think I've learned this when I was a teenager, and it just really stuck with me. I've been carrying it with me since. So thank you so much for coming. I really hope you've enjoyed your lunchtime, and hopefully see you again soon. Thank you.
What a treat. Thank you so much, Fionnuala. Thank you to Sharjan for the earlier performance, and thank you for being here. And you probably realise that we're in the middle of a construction site as the Strand is pedestrianised. Fortunately, most of the noises were still during the performance. And if you'd like to know more about what's going on around here, what we're trying to do at St Mary in the Strand, or the work of the Bath Festival Orchestra, please do stay and talk to us afterwards. Come again next time. We're doing the, especially the last Wednesday of every month for a free lunchtime concert at 1 o'clock. So do come along at the end of April, and see you again soon. And thank you again to our performers. Thank you. So many pieces I wasn't familiar with as well. It's a real treat.
Oh, thanks. That's why I like it.
Really nice sitting here. Your hands and music. Wow.
Ooh, what's going to happen here?
I could see it coming.
That's stuff I like to play.
Yeah, that's great. Really nice. Well done.
Thanks, that was really enjoyable. And what did